Well, hello there again, my YouTube friends. Just a different take on the old ZVS circuit tonight. I just thought I'd have a bit of a mess around with this because today I got in the post one of the radio transmitters from I'd ordered from eBay probably over a month or so ago. I ordered two of them for a slightly different project, but I thought I'd connect one of them up to the ZVS circuit and have a remote ZVS, which I'll show you working in a minute, but first I'll just zoom you in on the remote switch or the remote relay board and show you what it's all about. Okay, so as you can see, you've just got the normal flyback transformer, six windings around the core, or sort of six and six, you know. My normal ZVS circuit, which you can hardly see. I can pick it up because it's off. Let's see, in there. Under there. It's a bit messy, but it works. I've been meaning to put it on a circuit board, but I just haven't had time. Okay, so now we get to the relay board. This is what I got off eBay. It's a four channel remote switch with a wireless transmitter. Comes with this little fella here. It's got, obviously it's got, you can see the relay's clicking on it now. All controlled via that transmitter, operating at 315 megahertz, I believe. It's quite a good little unit. It can it's powered 12 volts, and I think it can handle up to about 5 amp. I think I'm right in saying that 5. I've got the details here, but I've only had this. I've only got this afternoon, so I've only been playing with it for a little tiny bit. 7 amps, 24 volts. It can do 10 amps. Operates on 12 volt DC, obviously, so I've got it running off this little power supply here, which outputs about 13 volts, I think, but that's no problem for him. So all I've got is the back of me, this power supply that I normally use for me flybacks, which is outputting 30 volts. I know the wires are long, I know all that. Don't be shouting at me. I've just thrown this together so you can see the remote flyback working. So yeah, so it's coming out of here. I've got it on the earth side of the flyback, so the load comes through straight through the flyback, and we've got the return path. I'm just using the return path, the earth through the relay, in the hope that it's just a bit less of a load once the power's used up through the flyback. So there's my little gap there to about. Let's see, can measure here. It is 35 mil. Not 35 mil. I know it's not much. It's I'm not trying to get it a massive arc. All I want to show you is the remote side of it. So I'll turn this thing on now and let you have a look. Okay guys, I'm across the other side of the room now. I'm about, let's say, about 5-6 feet in direct line away from the flyback or the receiver module. So I'll click on this remote now and hopefully we'll get some flyback arcs. There we go. I'll just turn it on and off. It's actually a latching switch in these, well, in the relay box over there. It's got four latching switches, so probably in one of the ICs. So actually, please, that's working. I expected it to work, but wasn't sure how good the actual radio, you know, the transmitter side of things would work. But it seems to be working just fine. I've got got a 10-foot lead on my microphone here, so I'm going as far away as I can. You won't hear any change in the sound from me because I'm connected directly to the camera via this long wire, but still working, as you can tell. In fact, it's working just fine. Actually seems weird standing right across the other side of the room triggering flyback arcs. As I say, we're operating on 30 volt there, or 32 volts. It's a pretty good flyback circuit, that, so I don't expect it to catch on fire or explode or anything. Not yet, anyway. See the end of that glowing now, that rod? I think you can. It's funny having two controllers in my hands, one for the camera and one for the trigger. Anyway, guys, just thought I'd show you that. Hope you liked the video. Take it easy. Speak soon. I've been playing with this for ages now. Thanks for watching, guys.